Africa, yeah. Africa, oh, oh. Africa's my people. Africa, my continent, too. Africa, yeah. Africa, oh, oh. Africa's my people. Make you listen to me, yo, yo. What is happening? What is going on? What is happening? What is going on? What is happening? What is going on? What is happening? What is going on?
Hey, man. It's good. I didn't see that post, but okay, cool, yeah. Hello, brother. How you hearing me, okay? I hear you fine, too. I wonder if, let me try this other mic real quick so you can work. Anything? Yeah, you hear me? Hear me now? Okay, let me put my headphones on so I don't get a peep. I'm on to the music. Share the light to share it, the stream. Okay. Okay. Cool. Cool.
And yes, here we are, BFF.fm Espresso Sesh. We got Afrolicious in the house, Mr. Diamond. Welcome, my friend. Hello.
Hello, hello. How you doing? How's everybody doing out there?
How's everybody doing
Diamond
out there?
Diamond vibes in the house.
Diamond vibes in the house.
MSK.
And we got Mr. Pleasuremaker all the way from LA in the phone. Hello, Mr. Pleasuremaker. How's it going, Joy?
What's up, my brothers? How y'all doing today?
Good, man. Good, good, very good. Like, yes, we're ready to start another episode of Espresso Sesh, actually, today, May 16. Episode number 71 of Espresso Sesh, all the way from the Mission District, San Francisco, California. We got a legend here from the neighborhood, from the city, Mr. Diamond Vibes. Today, we're going to talk about Afrolicious. We're going to Afrolicious, talking about the new record. You guys have a record release coming up soon. It's next week.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It's going to be at the Independent on Thursday, May 26th, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. So are you guys excited?
Very excited. I am very, very, very excited to bring the music back to San Francisco every time. You know, every time we do it, it's a beautiful experience. It's like coming home to your own bed, you know?
Yeah. So you guys have been in the city for a while, no? You guys started as a weekly party in the Mission like a few years ago, maybe nine years ago, something like that.
Yeah, man, it's like 10 to be exact, you know.
10 years ago, wow, time flies.
Yeah, May, this month, exactly, May 2007 was the first week of the month. And yeah, man, we did that party every week 7 years, and then we kind of helped put in another weekly party there for another year. So we were involved for 8 years, man.
Yeah, man, bringing the good vibes to the Mission District, to San Francisco, and then the weekly party developed slowly into a live band that so far has been releasing like many singles, like one album, full album, and this is next week is going to be the release of the next album. No, let's explain to us. Tell us what's up.
Yeah, man. Well, like you said, brother, and you have been one of the guys in that mix with us many a times.
Yeah, I've been there from the party.
So yeah, Diamond came in the mix. You know, all the other people in the band came in the mix. Mostly through that way, we had another live project called Pleasuremaker, but we essentially brought that thing together, and you know, with encouragement from friends and just the idea that the party's popping, let's make some original music. you know, from there we started making these original cuts. We got in with Garza and Thievery, and then that helped set up our first two EPs, which led to the first album, blah, 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 blah. Long and short, we're here now, years later with, you know, this would be like our third album. Our second was a remix album, but this would be like our second original album. And it's a continuation of, you know, what people have been digging about the live show and what they, what, you know, the positive feedback about the last record with some evolutionary elements, some new flavors. And, you know, and the truth is we have a lot of styles and things we still want to touch on and go deeper into yet that the party, if you remember, Anton, and, you know, that as you spun many a times, you know, we mix all those styles, anything from Brazilian to Asian to East and West African, you know, to old school to modern. So, you know, we're touching on a few more flavors, but I would say that this is a stepping stone to more flavors to come. So, you know, it's just a bigger piece. It's a piece in the bigger puzzle, you could say.
That's cool, man. Like, sounds very exciting. So there's going to be like new flavors in the music. So explore new territories.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's rooted in the same thing that people liked about the old album and what they like about the live show. Just, you know, some extension, some, you know, trying to chart some new territory, but, you know, keeping a foundation in what we've kind of been doing too. So it's got that root.
Cool. So the record is going to be ready on next week, no? For sale or like at the event or?
Yeah, no, that's a good question. To be very real, you know, we encountered some technical difficulties, some things that were out of our control and got pushed back a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're going to present it live, you know, so that people can hear it.
Okay.
You know, going to have maybe a download for the folks that come through and pay for the ticket so that they can actually access the album. And start leaking a few of the singles as we get prepared for the official release, which got pushed back. And meaning like when we're going to actually put it out through our distribution channels and when it's actually going to be produced. So the album is finished, but sadly, you know, some of the back-end stuff didn't get done in time due to unforeseeable circumstances, you know?
Yeah, but definitely there's going to be some goodies for who's going to be there, no? So like downloads or acts with the band, like pictures, I don't know, like...
Yeah, definitely, definitely. There will be something
get
for
that,
the people.
That exclusive experience, if you will, man.
Exactly,
you know?
Exactly.
Yeah, cool, man. And you guys are going to play the new songs live, no?
Oh, yes, we're definitely going to do a lot of our new stuff live.
Are you excited about the new material?
I am very excited about the new material. I think it's very different, much different than the California Dreaming album. I think it's a little bit more... You know, just it's got a little bit more flavor. You know what I mean? We put a little bit more into it. So I think the flavor is just going to be amazing and people are going to be really, really, really happy with it. So,
cool, man. Can't wait. Can't wait, actually, to listen to and check the music out. I mean, it's going to be good also to check you guys out live. Yeah. Last time I saw you, I mean, I've been seeing you like almost every week when you guys were like here in San Francisco. But it's been a minute since I saw you last time. I was for the Funkovit Festival or Guitar Fish.
Yes, it was, yeah.
Yeah, and I see you guys are, like, super tight as a band, like, jumping from a different rhythm, no? Like, you know, styles and rhythm. Like, even, like, in the old song, the song that we know already, no?
Yeah.
The arrangements were different and... keep things exciting. And
yeah, that's what we're trying to do, just keep the music exciting. You know, because, you know, as we do this for the people, you know what I mean? And so as long as the people are happy with what we do, we will continue to do it, you know? Because initially we play music for smiles and applause, you know what I mean, from the people that love what we do.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Diamond speaks the truth.
Yeah, it's nice to do like this kind of like one. We have like a piece of Afrolicious here live, and another piece of Afrolicious on Skype.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. But you know, it's good to have you like both, no, and see from like your own point of view. So there is nothing that we can play out. I think you sent me some link.
Yep. You can check it out. I'm. You know, that's a private link for you, brother. And then, like I said, we'll start making some of these joints more available.
So, you know, what you got to do is just to go to the Independent next week on Thursday and check them out. Like, new music, like, let's keep it, like, secret, no, till the release. And also, you know, in the build is going to be Lior Benur with his band Soltevel. Lior was a friend that was here a few months ago performing here at Espresso Sesh. And Will Maggid, also an old friend that is going to be part of the build next Thursday at the Independent. So better take it.
Friday.
It's on a Friday.
It's Friday. Okay.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, Friday on the 26th. Yes, with Afrolicious. Now, in the meanwhile, you're listening to some Saint Germain in the background, playing some records here, Espresso Sesh, BFF.fm. Diamond, you like this place?
Oh, I love this place. It's amazing, amazing. Lots of beautiful artwork and, you know, it's got that old-time feel to it, man. It reminds me of one of the old original studios. I feel like I'm in Studio One right now or something.
Yeah. But also the environment, no? Yeah. It's very artistic.
So yeah, it's very artistic. I love it.
It's cool. We keep it cool, and we do, every week with different guests. We keep it alive and vibrant. Today's Afrolicious, no? So we started the show actually with this California Dreaming, the joint. It was kind of nostalgic to listen to it, no? I remember those days. No, it was a few years ago.
Oh, I remember you came in when I was putting the final touches, and you kind of gave me a little tip and a little, you know, you threw in a little your flavor and Antonino, man, and that was cool, man. You remember that?
I definitely remember that. I remember the apartment on Valencia and 14, something like that.
Yeah, man, and I'll tell you what, too, that joint was wrote in that little apartment, and, you know, I remember that a lot of great artists I love, you know, they look around them, they say, oh, this is what's going down, and I go, I'm going to write that like that, you know, and I said, let me look out the street, and this is what's going down, this is what's happening. That's how the lyrics came together, man, just looking out the window of that apartment.
Oh, nice, yeah. I mean, it was a nice window with a nice fire escape, on Valencia, you got a little bit of the new San Francisco, the old San Francisco, you know.
Yeah, man.
A little bit in between, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. And now these songs are born in a different way. You know, you moved out of the city. You're living in LA. Can we tell this, no?
Yeah, no, it's cool, man. Yeah, I mean, it's evolution. You know, some of these joints, some of them were written in the city. You know, some were written in LA. You know, it's a transitional period for me personally, but you know, you see me all the time up there. The band keeps me rooted. The band and the gigs keep me rooted in Northern California partially. So I'm kind of split, you know, living the double life of Northern and Southern California, you know, trying to get it all.
Yeah, no, that's how you do it. No, that's how you should do it. And I think, I mean, probably you have a better fan base here in San Francisco than in LA, but you can build it out there too. And I've seen you guys have a nice schedule for the summer. So you guys going to play around in Cali, in Colorado, no? Something like that.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Go ahead, Dee.
Yeah, we're doing Denver for sure, you know, which is one of my favorite places. Cervantes is one of my favorite places to play in Denver. And so, yeah, we're doing Denver. We have some other shows in Colorado. We were doing Denver and
Fort Collins and Ouray and, you know, potentially some other places there. We're also going to go back and play Steamboat Springs later in the summer, September. Which, you know, hopefully we're going to play a number of joints that we just know we got that one already in September. And then, yeah, man, we have gigs booked all the way up until March of next year. I'm not going to announce what that is, but we have, you know, we have a number of festivals we're doing this summer. Real excited about what we're doing. First time at Enchanted Forest in Laytonville, California, Northern California. That's later in June. And also that same weekend, we're going to be up at Elk Fest in Spokane. We're really excited to come back to High Sierra Music Fest, which is our favorite, pretty much one of our favorite places we've ever played, man. They absolutely went nuts last time we played out there. Got a couple shows out there, you know, for the Funk of It Festival later in the summer. And, you know, yeah, man, we're just trying to ramp it up. You know, we want to really get out on the road and spread this music, man, you know, so.
Yeah, no, that's what you should do. It, no, you should spread the word and play it out, no, because you know, you have to it's the best way to promote your music, play it out, and you know, you get to see even among different other acts, not different other bands, and you know, I was telling Diamond, probably you were listening too, that I saw you guys at the Guitar Fish Festival last time live.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember? Oh, you, yeah,
That's so fun, man.
Back in July. It was almost a year ago. Huh? Time flies.
Wow, right? I know.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. But after that, you guys did Stan Grove. You played Stan Grove, and you played many many places. So, you know, the band is doing good. No, it's doing good, and...
Yeah, thanks, brother. Yeah, I mean, you know, and you've been there from the beginning, brother. Thank you again for your support, man. I really love you, and you know, we've had so many great times together, DJing together, playing together, and I really, you know, really want to shout out to you, Mr. MSK, for all your support through the years,
yes,
man. And
exactly.
You know, and you've seen it too. You know, we've just been trying to come out and have a great time, spread that love vibration, you know, bring all these amazing folks into the fold. I mean, like I said, just to reiterate, you came in and played some killer sets, you know. One of the other DJs who played the most times at Afrolicious besides you was, remember, DJ Concern from New York, you know, and he's a long-term friend still. And he's, you know, he's the kind of guy who's helped book us at places in New York, introduce us to friends there. So, I mean, through that party, you know, we've just created this love vibration. Diamond and I, look at us, too. I mean, we've become best friends and brothers through that party connection, and then the party has, you know, gave itself to the band. I know I'm kind of getting rambly here, but the long and the short is this thing was built out of love, and I know it sounds cliche, but it's true. We love the music, and Diamond said it himself, we're for the people, man. Like, we're not on any kind of trip. We don't think we're cool. We're not trying to be cool. We're just trying to, you know, make music that we love, you know, that we feel and that people can relate to, you know?
Yeah, no, sounds good, actually. Well, that's, like, just to underline what you said.
Yeah, you know, for me, I like bringing this music to the city, but the Mission is a very special place for me as far as, you know, the band coming together and the music coming together. And if I can continue to just bring this music to the Mission, you know what I mean, and bring it to the people here, and you know, that's where it started, and just spread it out through the universe, man, I think it's an amazing thing, because this is where it all began. And, you know, this area has, you know, given us so much support, you know. And so I want to keep it strong. I want to keep it Mission, man.
Yeah, Mission originated.
Exactly.
Mission made.
You know, I love this place, so.
Yeah, it was nice to... I met Diamond in a cafe, actually, Rev, we can tell this. And then we strolled down Mission Street to go to the session, no?
Yeah.
And it was nice to have this little stroll and see, like... You know, not that beautiful, not the most beautiful day today outside, but...
Yeah, but we have a beautiful day inside.
Inside, yeah.
Yes.
We, that's why, you know,
that's
like...
That's the thing, you know. Even if it's this area, though, even if it's not beautiful outside, it's definitely beautiful inside, and we have to keep the sunshine lit inside of ourselves, which sounds a little cliche, but, you know, it's the way it is, you know.
Yeah.
Mary Baba said, never judge the day by the weather.
Exactly, exactly.
You know, so, yeah, man.
Afrolicious in the house. You're listening to Espresso Sesh, episode 71, Best Frequencies Forever, with Mr. Joy Pleasuremaker live from Los Angeles on the phone here, and Mr. Diamond Vibes live from next
yeah, live, yeah.
In the Mission, like in the studio, BFF.fm. So these guys are gonna present a new album next week, next Friday. Next week on Friday at the Independent.
Yes.
And let's play some other joints from Afrolicious. I had to put you on all joy, if you don't mind, all right?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Actually, you know what? Actually, let me play some stuff from the record.
Yeah, can you access that link I gave you, brother?
I can access to the link you gave it to me.
Excellent.
But I have to shut you down.
Okay, no worries.
What is that, actually? Introduce us. Can you...
Yeah, feel free to give me a call back. Okay, so, like, you could pop off with, let's see, you know, why don't you start off...
Ways of Seeing.
Ways of Seeing? Okay, yes. Let's go with the title track, Ways of Seeing.
Okay, you send me this, here, SoundCloud, Ways of Seeing, mixes, okay.
Yep, Ways of Seeing. Drop that and then get back to me. No, I'm just joking.
All right. Yeah.
Should be the first.
Yeah. It's the first? Okay.
Yeah. See that?
So the Ways of Seeing is the name of the album, huh? Ways of
Yeah, exactly. It's it means, you know, obviously there's many perspectives out there, and you know, what your perspective is will determine your future, your history individually and then collectively. So the long and the short is that the long and the short is that, you know, with changing our way of seeing it, we can survive this upheaval and these difficult times, you know, and get to that next phase of evolution, you know.
And this is a way of seeing a new joint from Afrolicious, BFF.fm. We'll be right back in the on the air with Diamond and Joy. That was Afrolicious way of seeing. Yeah, I see. Let's go back with Joy as well on the. So new sound. The live video is not working. Yeah, Karina, thank you for watching us. There was some technical issue today, but you can listen to BFF.fm, and you're gonna have the experience for real, like no stopping.
Yes, you will.
Yes. So we got Mr. Pleasuremaker on the phone, and we got Mr. Diamond Vibes live here.
So, hey.
So this was a way of seeing, no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Brand new joint. Sneak preview. I like to do this, like sneak previews of unreleased stuff.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
So I can feel the energy on this joint. I can see the horns going, and I can see like the Afrolicious sound on this.
Excellent.
Joint. Excellent. Yes.
Yeah, man.
And you got to hear it first.
Yeah, we got to hear it first. Yes. Yes. Cool, man. So you know, I was the process of recording of this album. You started like the sketches, and then you brought together the band and.
Yeah, no, that's right, man. You know, we basically piecemeal what we can in terms of rehearsing, practicing, getting in the studio, due to the fact that we've been all living in different towns for a minute, and you know the complications that can arise from that. But you know, yeah, it's one of those things where a lot of times I kind of start the track and then I bring it to the band, and then you know we flesh it out, finalize whatever the final arrangement or recording will look like, you know.
Yeah, because you know, like there's remotely working also, no? Like, and in the meanwhile, let me just put this vinyl out. Yeah, and putting together, like, I mean, a band is tight, but like you said, everybody's living in a different place. So, It's like a, probably it's like a bit of like it took you a while to put together this album, no?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, we've been busy and everyone's busy, so that's not a real reason. But you know, just between touring and living different places, you know, for me personally, I had my second child during the first record and second, and moved to two different places. First, moved out of the city and stayed in the Bay, and then moved from the Bay to LA. So for me personally, it's been a very busy, crazy last 4 years between us touring and those life changes. But truth be told, you know, we have 5-6 albums worth of original songs during that period. We just haven't been able to put them out like we would have liked. You know, there's a lot of, you know, kind of budgetary concerns and stuff like that. So, you know, I think right now going forward, we're going to start putting out more singles, you know, hopefully every couple weeks or month or something. We got to just kind of steady stream of singles after this because we're sitting on a lot of material, you know.
Yeah, let's say that you guys started with a single like Blues for Mali, no? Like a few years mm-hmm. ago, you guys were noted by Rob Gatz of TV Corporation. He was the producer of your first singles, no?
Exactly.
And since then, you guys developed your own identity, also your own record label to release the stuff, the music, and consolidated, no? As a, you know, as a band, as a... You know, as like a movement, no? It's like a family, like gravitating with musician around, and you know. So it's nice to see you guys like developing, like on these years, no?
Thank you, brother.
Thank you.
Feels good. Feels natural. And we're really proud of all of our collaborators, man. You know, we're really looking at cats like Will Maggot's playing that show with us. You know, he's done amazing things since the early days.
Yeah.
You know, we had this thing called Pleasure Sessions. Will and I used to be kind of co-lead on that joint, you know, and Diamond was there, and, you know, our bassist Wendell was there, as were a number of other cats. You know, Alan came through, a bunch of horn players came through, and, you know, one of our former drummers and dear friends to this day, Paul, was there. Long and the short, you know, that's where we met Zeke. Zeke came in. He was about 18, 19.
Yeah, yeah.
Now he's out there, you know, touring the world with Combrio. You know, Will's putting out these amazing records. You know, Zeb's already doing his thing when he joined up with us, but he still plays guitar with the band, but he's the leader of Smoked Out Soul, which Will plays in, and our former, you know, percussionist dear friend. And when I say former, nobody's really a former member of Afrolicious, you got to understand. But, you know, Kike, he used to play the party every week. He plays with Smoked Out Soul. Long and the short, all these people come together with, you know, collaborate with each other outside and beyond Afrolicious. Yourself, MSK, you were doing your thing, you know, before us and separate from us, but we're, you know, you're a collaborator. And you
yeah,
know,
actually, you guys may let me play it for the first time in San Francisco. So.
Oh, cool, man. Cool. Yeah, and just, you know, other bands that we've supported and loved, like the Pimps of Joy Time, Orgone, you know, Brownout from Austin. I mean, all these bands that we really love and support, DJs that we love, and individual artists like Nicodemus and Nappy G. I mean, all these people, you know, we supported, they supported us. And you know, it's like some of them are precursors to us, like Nicodemus and that Nappy G, Turntables on the Hudson's, you know, DJ Smash. These are cats who came before us, who did music that we were feeling, and we kind of try to carry on those vibes. And, you know, it's just long and short, Jay Boogie. I mean, there's just a lot of people in our extended network that we love near and dear to our heart. And when we see them thrive, we know the Afrolicious model is expanding like we hoped it would, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, it's good because, like, I think probably the city was missing, like, a scene like yours. So it was good to have you. And actually, we're kind of missing you now. Like.
Yeah, exactly. And we miss the city, man. We miss playing here more. We miss our weekly, you know. We miss our people that are there every week consistently. Like, you know, and Afrolicious, like you were saying earlier, you know, it's not just a band. It's a collaborative family, you know. All these different people, you know, from around the world that have come, you know, come together with us. And like Joey was saying, collaborated with us. It's probably one of the most amazing things on the planet if you look at it, you know, because like I said, we've just come together with so many different artists, you know, and created this sound, and it's created through everybody, you know, like Joey was saying, all the people that have worked with us have helped us to create that sound also, you know.
Yeah, and it's kind of a signature now, but talking about the sound, actually the sound, the name, no, you remember the song Afrolicious by the Dining Rooms?
Yeah. Definitely.
Actually, I remember talking to you with about like this, like Dining Rooms, like Gerardo Frisina, all this Italian music that were not that famous in the outside. I mean, in the States, outside like some clip, like some niche of listeners. You know? And you guys were like loving this music, so I brought some stuff here. I'm gonna play. Yeah, remember those days. Let's start with Bosque from I think it's Boston in the East Coast. With this takeover joint. And yes, we are with turntables up. And let's go back. Let's talk again in a second. Let's enjoy this. It's part of Whiskey Barons. Bosque.
Yeah, yeah. Love those guys.
Yeah. Espresso Sesh.